Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about those pesky pre-order numbers for Infinite Warfare. I've seen a lot of Call of Duty channels, as well as a lot of channels not related to Call of Duty in any way, shape, or form, talking about how low the pre-order numbers for Infinite Warfare is. Now, everybody's going to be drawing these numbers from a website called VG Charts. I'll put a link down below in the description, but you can actually see right here on the screen via the screenshot that the Infinite Warfare numbers for the PlayStation 4 as well as the Xbox One are considerably lower than what we saw last year with Call of Duty Black Ops 3. And we'll talk about that in just a moment. So another thing that I want to bring up really quick, VG Charts does not actually count how many digital pre-orders there are, so we are just going based off of physical copies. But even so, last year with Black Ops 3, you can see that there is a huge difference. So why would this happen? What could possibly be the reason behind this? Normally, when you think of Call of Duty in this day and age right now, you don't really look at the game as a single-player experience. You look at the game as you're going to buy it for the multiplayer experience. And last year with Call of Duty Black Ops 3, we began to get multiplayer information extremely early. And just to put it into perspective for you guys, we already had multiplayer information early in May. That is a big deal, because if they took the same exact route that they did last year with Black Ops 3, we would already know what to expect in the multiplayer for Infinite Warfare. Sure, we've had a little bit of teasers and stuff like that, but we already had rock hard solid gameplay and stuff like that in the beginning of May for Black Ops 3. There is a reveal trailer, it came out on June 15th, but that was just the reveal trailer. We already had gameplay, and that's unprecedented. We didn't have that before from previous years with Call of Duty. We actually had footage of the pre-alpha that was circulating the internet and everything like that, and it really did bring a lot of new fans into the game overall, and that really did drive the pre-order numbers. Now, as of right now, comparing it to last year, this year in 2016, we're already almost halfway through June, and we don't know anything about the multiplayer. We haven't seen any gameplay. We haven't seen a teaser. We hadn't seen anything yet. And, I mean, if we hop back to 2014, the same thing could be said about Advanced Warfare. The trailer didn't come out until August, so we might get a teaser trailer soon. I really, really, really hope we do. But just thinking a little bit logically, I really feel like that's one of the biggest reasons why these pre-order numbers are so extremely low, is because we don't know anything about the biggest portion of what this game is for a lot of people. Now, I'm not going to say that people aren't pre-ordering it just because they don't want to pre-order it. That's probably the case, too. Nobody wants to be in the future anymore. Nobody wants the new jump systems. Nobody wants anything like that. But obviously, we're going to have something like that continuing over the years. I just really hope that they kind of tone it down a bit and bring it back to its core. That's one of the main reasons why I love Call of Duty, because it's always so simplistic to play. You can just pick up the controller, go in, do whatever you got to do, and put the controller down and walk away if you're done playing, or continue to play to rank up and just do stuff like that. I really miss the simplicity behind it, and I think every year as the game evolves, it starts to add things more and more that people just don't like and start to dislike. But just from somebody who's been playing from the beginning, and I know I've brought this up before, it's really crazy to see just exactly how much our player base has evolved. Not only just the game, but the people that have been included into the player base. There are new players that come to Call of Duty every single year. There are people that are going to get this game for Christmas that have never heard of Call of Duty. There are people that are going to get this game for their birthday that have never played Call of Duty. There's always new people joining on, and there's always people that are leaving the series as well. And I think that it's kind of that zen balance between being one of the biggest first-person shooters of all time and having a ton of fans either coming and going all at the same time, and it's kind of just been lowering every single year. Yes, it is no secret to anybody that the player count has been declining over time, but it's still a really fun game nonetheless, and I think that it is to each their own on how people play the game and whether or not they decide to even pre-order or pick it up or buy it at that point. And I just want to make it very clear, I still haven't even pre-ordered the game. Reason being is because it's so extremely early. I'm waiting to see what the multiplayer is like. Sure, I'm still going to play the game. I think that it's going to be a great installment to Call of Duty, just like it is every year, but I just haven't pre-ordered yet. My number hasn't put on that chart yet, and I always get it physically, but I just wanted to throw that out there. Not everybody has pre-ordered yet. People really haven't had it on their minds. It's still extremely early, but at the end of the day, people are going to decide what they decide to do. Like I said, I'm still planning on buying the game, but I haven't even pre-ordered yet. I'm not really interested in pre-ordering it either, unless they announce some sort of prestige edition or something like that. And I don't know if they're going to do that. I'm kind of holding off on stuff like that because usually in a like a prestige edition, you get some sort of figurine or like night vision goggles or something cool like that. And I just got a shelf full of nerd things that I like to stick these things on. So I'm waiting for something like that. A lot of other people might be waiting for something like that as well. There really hasn't been any major pre-order incentive either, except for a couple posters. And you can honestly just go to GameStop and ask for one and they'll give you one. That's pretty much how I look at it as. But once again, to each their own, I really don't care about the numbers. I'm still going to play the game and you bet your ass I'm going to be on Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered. That's just how it goes. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video here today, don't forget to click the like button down below and subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. We're super close to 1 million. I appreciate all of the continued support. And until tomorrow, I will see ya. Peace.